The two retrieved bodies are part of the three people who drowned in River Rizi at Nyankizi, one of the four bridges that collapsed due to heavy downpour that flooded River Rizi. The three drowned as they were in a locally made canoe trying to cross the river from Katete to Nyankizi areas. One body of Tarema Aloysius, commonly known as Rasta, is still missing.
Following the drowning incident that occurred on Monday this week, our team of divers, working together with the fire and rescue services team, have been able to retrieve two bodies, one of Timothy Kapuru and the other not identified yet. So these two bodies are both going to be taken to Mbare Regional Fire Hospital mortuary, where we request members of the public to come and be able to view these bodies and be able to identify, especially the one that hasn't been identified.
According to Kasasira and the marine divers, the search of the remaining body is still ongoing. Police marine divers started the search after attempts by local divers to retrieve the bodies became futile. Police warned people living near River Rizi to be extremely careful, especially this period when the water levels in River Rizi are high.
The search is still going on, and our team, as I told you, the divers from marine.
I'm giving advice in this season. We're in the rain season where water is over flooding. Majorly, the people who stay are close of the river. When the water is flooded, don't cross. I'd rather sleep at a relative or at a friend until the water goes down.
Divers revealed that retrieving bodies from River Rizi is very difficult since the river is full of stones and the water is at a very high speed.
The river is, we are facing a challenge where the water is running fast. It's a running water which has very many stones, rocks, which is making our work difficult of diving and searching. But we are still on. We have not given up. We are still searching until we get the remaining body.
Relatives and friends of the deceased hailed police for efforts that helped them to get the bodies of their people. They urged the government to intervene and construct bridges for them. The fatal accident occurred at Nyankizi Cell, where there is an abandoned bridge project that was half constructed over 30 years ago. The Monday heavy downpour destroyed four other access bridges, forcing people to look for alternative means of crossing the river. On 4th of May 2023, environmentalists warned for more environmental disasters as a result of degradation of river catchments. River Rizi has lost the biggest percent of water catchment due to degradation by human encroachment and poor agriculture practices. Rizi is the biggest river in the Greater Ankole region, and it has a catchment of 8,700 square kilometers. Report by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.